Meyer's theory is that the siege trench in the aerial image was dug during the destruction of Gath 3,000 years ago.
The siege trench is the first clue that something's there that needs investigation.
What's really cool about this photograph is that nobody has ever noticed this before. We're talking about centuries here, where this huge trench has been hidden in plain sight. That's pretty incredible.
Meyer heads to the site to begin the investigation on the ground. Drone footage confirms the feature he detected in the 1945 aerial photograph.
We have this enormous, if you want, ginormous, feature. It would have required tens of thousands of hours of work of thousands of laborers. And this was done for the sole purpose of besieging this site.
If Meyer is right, the legendary city of Gath could lie beneath this hill. Meyer's task now is to find conclusive evidence that this location really was the home of Goliath. Excavations continue, and the dig team discovers the base of a huge structure positioned in front of the remains of a temple. For Meyer, the structure confirms the site was once a great city.
Right over here, we have a gate, and this we believe is one of the gates of the city of God, more or less the time of David.
David may have once stood at this very spot in an attempt to gain entrance to the fortified city.
Imagine David coming over here, and he would be at the entrance to the gate. The gate was probably several stories high.
Proof that David's giant opponent lived at this site remains elusive. But as Meyer's team continues, they unearth what might be a vital clue.
We found an inscription which has on it two names which are very, very similar to the name Goliath.
It may just be coincidence, but when you find pottery with a name like Goliath on it, you can't help but wonder.
Gath, the city of Goliath and refuge of King David, lost for centuries, found by a camera in the skies.